you have a situation where you have demand is going up at the same time supply is being withdrawn or pulled back. When demand goes up and supplies goes down, prices start to take off. But if demand exceeds supply, if there's people need more power than it's on the grid, that's when you end up in blackout territory.
There's a large fraction of the coal plants that are now offline, they're not operating. So the estimate is about 20-25% of the coal fleet is actually not working. The consequence of that is that there's a shortfall in capacity, which is normally supplied by those generators. And so that capacity does exist in the market, but it's made up by other generators, so other coal-fired power stations, for example. But they operate at a higher capacity level, and so they become less efficient and things become more expensive. And so that is that some of those plants prefer not to sell. Why is it that those plants prefer not selling? It's because the regulator stepped in, decided to impose the price cap, which is, you know, from the perspective of a consumer is high, from the perspective of a plant is low. For most consumers, they'll barely notice, except if we do see a blackout, of course. If you see a blackout, then, you know, it's a disaster for anyone affected, but most consumers will not notice. You will get probably a notice from your supplier in the mail or in the email saying, we have to increase your prices. I got one of those last week, and I think the price increase was in the order of 10%.
So we're seeing the government acting on this and putting shining a very bright public light on this with these electricity companies. But you know, whether or not we ultimately see demand actually outstrip supply and we see a blackouts or rolling blackouts or anything like that remains to be seen.
We are, you know, witnessing the transition to clean energy, and this has consequences. It doesn't happen just by itself. Transition to clean energy is a good thing. It's something which I think most of us would agree is desirable. But the consequence of that is that we progressively retire those large plants from a world which was highly, highly controllable, where if you wanted to produce electricity, you just had to, you know, increase the heat rate of the plant, to one where it very much depends on whether we have supply of, say, wind or sun.
Renewables, you know, become bigger and bigger part of the grid, and there's, you know, less and less incentive to keep coal-fired power stations and these sorts of things going, and there's political pressure and these sorts of things coming through green energy policy. You might think that these large players are trying to raise the idea that, you know, we're gonna, if we don't support coal-fired power and we lose that, you know, that power base, some of this instability might be coming with the push for renewables, and they're taking advantage of their size to try to send shockwaves through the system along those lines.